For this video, I'm using database ODB61 standalone forms and the standalone forms I created in video 61. I'm going to create a new form. So I'm in forms. I'll create this form in design mode. I'm coming up to format, page. I'm on the background tab and I'm going to change this background color to be yellow 9. Apply, OK. Now I'm going to add in a label. I'm going to right click on it, open up the property control, and change that label to be standalone, shift enter, switchboard. And I want to change the font to the font of Cooper Black, and I'll change this to 28, font size of 28. Let's also change this alignment from left to center. Now I want to add some buttons. Add 1, 2, and 3. Clicking on the first one, I'm going to change that label to say add new record. Then I'm going to come down to the action and change that to say open document slash web page. That makes my URL text box active. I'm on the desktop and there's my add new employee. Let's do the same thing with the next button down. We'll make this employee search form. Coming down to our action, open document or web page, clicking on our URL, dot, dot, dot. We want the employee search form open. And now we're on to our third button. This one's going to be our employee edit form. Again, come down to our action, open document web page, and make that employee edit form open. I want to select all three buttons. I want the width to be 2 inches and the height to be 0.6. Let's give them all a different font. We'll stick with the Cooper Black. Make that 12. Let's change the color. We'll make it violet. Better change that width to be just a little bigger, 2.25. That looks good. I want to move these out a little to the right, so I want to select everything. And for some reason, it's not letting me move my standalone switchboard label. Looking at the anchor, we see that it's anchored to as a character. We want to anchor this to the page so we can move this around. Now I'm going to select everything again. And now I can move this to the right and down. I'm going to add a rectangle just for fun to add a little more color to this. We're going to give it no fill color, and I'm going to make the border a little thicker, 22, 24, somewhere in there. Try and get it centered a little bit. That looks pretty good. I'm going to save this. and I will give it the name Switchboard. My title doesn't really stand out that much. I'm going to select that and change that background. Let's make that yellow. There we go. And save. Now when I go into design mode, if I click on add new record, it opens up my standalone form, add new employee. Same thing for my search and my edit. Let's go back into edit mode. Now I want to save this. Save copy as. I'm going to put this on my desktop. We're going to call this Standalone Switchboard. Save. Close. We'll save our database. Opening up our Standalone Switchboard, I'm going to double click. And try and open up the Add New Record. We get an error. What I need to do is go into design mode. I'm going to right click on this button, open up the control, and down under this URL, I'm going to just connect in the add new employee again. Same thing for the employee search form. Employee search and employee edit. Let's close this and reopen it. Now when I click on add new record, it opens up the add new employee. And so does the employee search form and the edit form.